One of my specialties as a psychotherapist is sexuality. I'm a sex therapist. And sex therapy is psychotherapy. It's talk therapy. Sex therapists do not touch or lay their hands on their clients. They do initiate homework for their clients. One of the homework assignments I'm going to tell you about is one that I think will benefit you so much in all your life, whether you're just getting together or whether the two of you have been together forever. Sensate focus is a way of making love that you can always go back to because it doesn't include intercourse. It includes touch, and touch is the most vital component to a healthy intimacy and physical relationship with your partner. Sometimes in life, people get traumatized. You may find yourself loving someone who has been sexually traumatized. That includes rape, harassment, growing up with an abusive parent, being raped by a teacher or a coach, or being raped by anyone, date rape. Rape in itself is a criminal act against the victim. And therefore, anytime a person has been traumatized sexually, they're going to have sex with a trusted partner in a very different way, and one that requires patience on both ends. The second type that Sensate Focus that I'm going to talk about works fantastic with is anyone recovering from a debilitating disease or an accident or cancer. People who have had cancer and were treated many times initiate through this process of Sensate Focus that I want to talk about. And this is their sex life for a long time until they can renew their strength and their feeling of touch and being able to orgasm again, feeling like they can trust their body. The homework I'm going to give you today, if you will, it's not really homework, but it's a lesson, is based on a 1960s theory of Sensate Focus. Yes, that is a very old practice, but it is one of the best ones, and I use it today so much, and my couples absolutely have decided that they will keep this a part of their lovemaking. It is not penetration. It is not anything like what traditionally you'll see on TV as sex, but it is sex, and it is incredible intimacy. But you have to take about an hour. You have to allow at least an hour. And I usually recommend that clients who try this experiment set up a date, and they basically try to set up two dates a week, and these dates revolve around Sensate Focus. But before I get into that, let me just go through a very short list of what Sensate Focus has been noted most effectively for. It's a mutual responsibility between partners for addressing sexual needs and concerns. It's information and education about sexual function and sexual activity. You're going to be talking to your partner during this time. A willingness to change attitudes about sex. Getting rid of sexual performance anxiety. That means if you're struggling with premature ejaculation or maybe erection difficulty disorder, you're going to be able to enjoy Sensate Focus. Heightening couples, it oftentimes improves couples' communication that was hidden in the past. It allows them a space and an intimacy to talk openly about things they may have been embarrassed or shameful about. It reduces problematic behaviors like withdrawing from sex, like not wanting to be touched at all. And if you practice this homework, you're going to develop a better give and take in your sex life and in your communication. It relies solely on both partners saying yes, giving permission, yes, this is okay. And during the whole time that you're being touched by your partner, you have a right to say no at any time. And secondly, It allows you each a space to be safe and to just feel, think, and then talk with your partner in that safe space. Okay, so this is the way you start it. Two times a week if you can. If that's too much, start with one time a week. And you must be in an area where you can be alone, it's quiet, and you start out with a bath and or a shower, warm shower, whatever your preference is. That part is done on your own until you get feeling better, and then you want to encourage each other to take a shower with you or a bath. Then you simply lay on a towel, and preferably if you're in pain or if this is going to help you with alleviate your pain, maybe after cancer, then you lay on a bed, but put a towel underneath you so that if you get oil on it, you won't scar the sheets or the comfort or anything. And then what you do, you put on soft music, you light candles, you make the room slightly dark, and one partner decides to go first with being the patient, if you will. And the other is going to be the healer. And so the healer is the partner, and they oil their hands or they put massage oil on their hands. And then their job is to just massage, touch mildly all the areas on the whole body. You do not have to be nude for this experiment. Some people who lose a breast or maybe they have a colostomy bag, they're very embarrassed about the way they look. Or if you were sexually shamed, you're going to feel bad about your body. That's okay. Put on a camisole and light shorts. If you're a guy, you can wear a t-shirt, although t-shirt, it covers up a major area for massage. I would recommend shorts. And maybe if you could go bare-chested, that would be ideal. The most important thing in the first exercise is you stay away from the genitals. You massage each area of the person's body, and as you massage it, you just listen. You listen to relax, you listen to what you're feeling, and you listen to what your partner says. Some things feel so good, or sometimes we carry great pain in different areas of our body, and when they're touched, we'll be frightened, we'll startle. That just means you're healing. And if you can, if it feels good and you trust your partner, just ask them if they'll massage that area. Sometimes you can massage a bad memory or a hurtful touch you used to remember away if it's done with a healing, loving partner. After this, after you do one person, and you should allow at least 20 to 30 minutes, then you switch partners. And the other partner is going to be the patient, if you will. And this time you get to be the healer or the loving partner, and you do the same type of massage to your partner. It's important you listen for feedback during this time. In the traditional Sensate focus, we used to follow a format that we didn't introduce the genitals or have those massaged until after 4 weeks of doing this. But depending on your level of need, you may want to shorten it, maybe 2 weeks, so you'd have 4 sessions with no genitals. And then it's okay to lightly go into massaging the genitals. You may say, well, this is going to just get me turned on. And learning to breathe through that turn on and appreciate being turned on and wanting your partner is important. But as much as possible, stay away from making it about sex. And I say that because you're creating a safe space for physical intimacy without intercourse. And your partner needs that. You both need that. That's going to strengthen your marriage. And it's going to open you that when you're touched, instead of recoiling or feeling like no and pushing them away, you're going to be open to them coming closer because you remember that safe space and you remember that they can touch you without wanting anything else from you or needing anything else from you. And that's a freeing feeling. If you're concerned about, is this for you? There are certain disabilities we know for sure this helps a lot with. I shouldn't call them disabilities because some of these are temporary transitions. If you're having pain during sex, if you, like I mentioned, have premature ejaculation or erectile dysfunction, or if you have an arousal disorder, this helps immensely, or any kind of desire disorders. Just try it. It being open and available and trusting your partner to begin something new, and it is something new, it's an adventure, I think really heightens sexuality. And not only that, it's gonna make you feel good about yourself. You're a confident couple. If you do this, you can do any other thing too. Try something new.